find a doctor. Find a doctor. Need a doctor!
Let's see some smiles. To the victors go the spoils.
Seriously, it's Lucas, right? Man, you gotta join the league. It's so fun.
I would, but I don't really.
I blinked. Mess everything up. You can't hang it up if I blinked.
I promise.
I got one word for y'all. Rematch.
Oh, are you ready to get beat again, Caleb?
All right.
Yes?
One more.
Yes.
Then I gotta. I lost track of time. I can't.
What are we gonna tell our fans? We can't keep them waiting.
I really can't. It's nice to meet you though, right?
Alright. Cool.
Get down on the floor. Back door. Back door!
There isn't one.
What?
It's an old bar, it doesn't go through.
You mean I'm trapped?
That is the only door, I swear.
There's 100 cops outside.
Look, man. No back door. The only way out of here is...
Never tell the guy with the gun what his options are. Got it?
Yeah. I got it.
Okay. We're in this mess together now. Together.
Hey, if you need a hostage, just take me and let everybody else go.
Everybody shut up! I need to think.
Didn't the cops just come in?
No.
Oh, God. What if they just start shooting everybody?
Down, Suze.
No, really, if they just start shooting...
Shut up.
It's okay. They'll hang back. They'll form a perimeter, and then they'll seal off the block. And they'll establish contact with the bar. How do you know?
All right, here's the score. We're all just gonna hold tight until I can...
What do I do?
Answer it.
And say what?
You cut us some slack, man. It's our first hostage situation.
Just stall them! Okay, I need to think. Do it.
Hello?
Phone's in the bin. Phone.
Look, I don't have one.
City doesn't have one, man.
All right. I'm not coming in.
What'd you say?
I said if they came in, you'd kill us all.
Good.
Good?
Everybody sit down and shut up. We're gonna wait this thing out.
For how long?
As long as it takes.
Anyone else?
He's gonna let us go, you guys.
What makes you say that?
He's got to. It's his only option. He's gonna figure it out eventually. We just gotta give him more time.
He's already had 4 hours.
He's not gonna let us go. They're gonna start shooting, or he's gonna start shooting.
Suze, calm down. Everyone just calm down. We're gonna give ourselves heart attacks just sitting here. We gotta do something. Pass the time.
Hey, how about one of your hypotheticals?
Yeah, all right.
Now, what's that?
Oh, Caleb comes up with these interesting hypotheticals. Our icebreakers kind of, they pass the time. They're fun.
So, if you could choose between the power of flight and invisibility...
Everybody already knows that one.
Not everyone knows it. Plus, he got it from the radio.
I did.
I've got one. Okay, so... let's say you could know with 100% certainty the exact moment you were gonna die.
You're really asking that right now?
What is wrong with you? All right, let's say everyone has one round trip ticket in a time machine. Where would you go with yours?
Okay.
I like that.
Okay, so what are the rules? I mean, these things always have to have rules, right?
Yeah, you can go anywhere?
Well, anywhere on Earth. I mean, this isn't, you know, Doctor Who.
At any time.
Yeah.
I'd go back and convince myself not to marry my husband.
It's a nice one, but you can't.
Why not? Oh, he sucks.
Well, I believe you, but if it already happened, it happened. You can't change past events.
Oh, wait, but what's the point? I mean, if you can't go back 300 years and open a bank account or, I don't know, save JFK.
Kill Hitler.
Classic.
Yeah, I mean, if you can't go back and change things, if you can't go back and fix things, why go?
That's a good point.
Well, lots of reasons. Just to be there, for one. You know, see how it really happened. See if history got it right. To touch it, you know. Smell it. Experience it for yourself, you know? Not online or in a newspaper, but to be there.
Oh, I know what I'd do. I'd set up shop on the deck of the Titanic. I mean, to be there and see something like that, that would be amazing.
That's depressing.
That's history.
I know what I'd do. I go back to Hollywood in the 60s. Dropping the last with Jim Morrison. Just saying.
Oh, my God.
What's wrong with that?
One shot in a time machine. You want to go relive your hippie college phase?
Says the girl who wants to watch 1,000 people drown and freeze to death. Never let go, Mickey. Never let go. Oh, well, that's mine. How about you, Suze?
All right. Jesus.
Mm-hmm. It's a lot to think about.
No, I'd meet Jesus. I don't know. I just want to know, you know? If he was real or not. If he was who he said he was. Son of God and all that. I mean, I know they spoke other languages back then. I wouldn't have to understand the words. Just want to be there. See it for myself instead of hearing it from someone else for once.
Well, you did not go small, Suze. Yeah.
What about you, David?
I want to see the future.
Wait, is that allowed?
The future? Yeah, sure, why not?
What's in the future?
I don't know, hope, world peace. A vacation house on the moon. I don't know, we live in tough times, you guys. Turn on the news, hell. Look out your window. I mean, everywhere you look, there's suffering. But then I think about the internet. Okay, when I was born, it didn't even exist. And now we all carry it around in our pockets like it's nothing. I mean, every day this world gets smaller and smaller. And that's a good thing. That's progress. And over time, this shrinking world is going to become beautiful. I mean, it's not going to happen overnight, but it's going to happen, you guys. And that I'd like to see.
God, I hate optimists.
You're wrong, you know, about the future.
How do you know? It hasn't happened yet.
The world never changed because it's full of people. And people have been the same since the day we crawled out the mud. The rich get rich, the poor get poor, and the rest of us just try not to end up under somebody's boot. That's who we are. That's our nature.
But, I mean, we have free will. We can change our nature.
No, we can't. Our choices were made for us. You just don't want to see that.
Come on, you're making a choice right now.
You call this a choice? You know what I did? You know, before all this, I was a welder. But now all the factories and jobs are gone. Forever. You know what? That's your progress. What I used to do, what I trained my whole life for, they got robots now. Robots are easier. They don't complain or get sick, and they don't have families to provide for. They don't have families. I wasn't coming home empty-handed again. You think I'm making a choice here, now? This choice was made the moment I was born.
Look, man, maybe there's still time for me.
This game is over.
You got kids, Lucas?
Yeah. Yeah, I got two. I got a six-year-old named Caden. He looks just like his granddad. I got a four-year-old named Jules. She looks just like her mother. She's real cute.
My wife and I are trying right now. Her idea. I love her so much, and I want to give her everything that she wants in this world. But sometimes I...
You don't feel ready.
Yeah. People tell me an adult, but I don't really feel like one, you know?
My wife wanted kids from the first day that I met her. She came from a really big family. It was more of a brood, really. And she loved it. But for me, my dad, growing up, he wasn't around. Yeah, I guess that's why I fought it for so long. Well, what if the same thing happened to me? I didn't want my kids to be alone like I was. It was tough, you know, growing up without a dad. I would have done anything to change that.
So how'd you get over it? That fear?
What about the kids?
Yeah.
I didn't. It's still there sometimes, and it's just, I don't know, I guess, I guess love won out, you know?
So did you?
Did I what?
Did you turn out like your father?
No, I see my kids every day. Every moment I spend with them is a gift. Yeah, you're a good man, Daniel. You're kind. You're loyal. And you don't gotta worry about it. And you'd be a great father.
Thanks, man.
Listen, there's something I should...
What's that? Oh, God, it's the cops.
Wait, what?
I can get out of here.
Shoot, wait. Don't make me shoot you.
Wait. Oh, God.
No, wait. Grab the handgun.
Whether it is into my future after all.
No. Actually, Daniel, your wife is already pregnant. Okay, Olivia's already pregnant. You're going to have a son.
How could you know?
Because 8 months from now, I will be born.
That's impossible.
No, if I could take a trip in a time machine, and I could go anywhere, and I could talk to anyone I want. I would go back, and I would meet my... I would meet my father.
See, I never met him because he... He was shot, and he was killed 8 months before I was born.
I'm glad I'm here. You're not alone. Okay, you're not alone for this. You're not alone. You're not alone. Dad, you're not alone.
Welcome home, Lucas. The current temperature is 72 degrees. Caden and Jules are in the backyard.